What's poppin', Dota people? Welcome back to the Chinese Qualifiers for the International here on the EU Hub, sponsored by joinDOTA. My name is Gorgon the Wonder Cow. I've been with you all night. I was with you all night last night, and hopefully I'm now starting to get just a little bit of an understanding of this crazy thing they call Chinese Dota. And joining me for his inaugural journey into the glory land that is Chinese Qualifiers, this is Toffees coming in.
Glad to be here. If you guys like what you're hearing, at Toffees underscore Dota 2. And I'm excited to be here for Join Dota with Gorgon to bring you the Chinese Dota's last round prior to tiebreakers. It does look like we're going to see some potential tiebreakers today. Probably a couple. Looks like it might be a three-way tie for fourth place right now.
Yeah, there is a lot of potential for some shenanigans going on here. Of course, fourth place right now is DT sitting at 5-2. LG, DC, DEC. Wow, I put a lot of weird emphasis on those letters, are 5-3. So if DT lose their current match, they will end up going into a tie for three-way. Tong Fu is sitting at 5-3 as well. And let's see, CIS is sitting at 4-3 with the opportunity to get up to their fifth spot here, as well as HGT sitting at 4-4 and looking to get up to their fifth spot here. So we're gonna have one more round, not here on this channel, but on some of the other channels like LGD versus DT. It's gonna be on our primary channel, casted by Capitalists over there at twitch.tv/joindota, I believe. You guys can of course find all that over on joindota.com to figure out where the matches are being hosted, because I don't have it all memorized, but there are a couple of matches going on right now as well. So we're gonna be looking at, I don't see a way for this to shape up without at least one big tie coming out.
Yeah.
And, Hyper Glory Team, they want to be in on that.
Yeah, so Hyper Glory Team really needs to take this to keep themselves in the hunt. SPG could win, and maybe with some crazy math mechanics, get themselves into the playoff for the four. But HGT, if they win this, they will legitimately be in contention to be in that fourth place playoff.
Yeah, so, I mean, yeah, here's the deal with Speed Gaming. If they win this, they are still going to be tied up at a lower rank. I mean, they're going to be tied up at that four spot. That won't actually get, or with four wins, that won't actually get them into the top four, but it will get them right on the cusp of it. The HGT, if they win this, they are hot in contention for top four. And of course, if they don't win this and CIS doesn't win their game here, or any of their remaining games, I guess I should say, then the top four are settled. Then it's going to be Tong Fu, both LGDs, and then DT. But CIS and HGT are in position to kind of throw a stick in the spokes of success for one of those teams. And they're going to do everything they can to make that happen. So let's talk about the draft a little bit. Axe coming out. That's here. We see a little bit over here on the side of the Chinese Dota. We have seen Axe. I casted at least one other Axe game so far. Yeah, he's actually been played twice so far. Both of them wins. For this tournament. So, taking a look, that was played by, looks like XTT played one. And then, go ahead.
So I was saying, neither of these teams really focusing on their top pick heroes. A little bit in the sense of Speed has grabbed the Doom and the Dazzle, two heroes that they've used a fair amount in this tournament. Dazzle has been picked up a bunch of times and has had kind of mixed results for them. He's actually lost more than he's won. So interesting how they play him out here. Hyper Glory Team, on the other hand, is interesting to me, as they, all of four of their picks, if you were to say go into their last 10 matches or so and take a look at all of their pro level picks, none of these guys show up in the picked more than once section.
For Hyper Glory Team, even the Train Protector, that is surprising to me.
Yeah, I'm looking at right now. I've got the last eight games pulled up, because that's all that I could get pulled on DAT. And right now, Train Protector hasn't been picked more than once.
Huh? Interesting. Hyper Glory Team is, of course, they're actually one of the two teams that have run the Axe already so far this tournament, and seem to have a fair diversity of heroes coming behind them. You've got the stats pulled up, so you can let me know, but I think Hyper Glory Team is probably one of these heroes, or one of these teams that we've been seeing with more diverse drafts than the rest of the Chinese squads.
HGT, let me pull up that HGT section here. I want to make sure I was looking at the right one, since they are both scrolled down. They have an incredibly varied draft, in the sense of the only exceptions to that, I would say, are Rubick, Sand King, and Invoker. They enjoy playing those heroes a lot, and we've seen a lot of those picks recently, especially in terms of that Sand King. So as they go into this next support pick, I wouldn't be, I'm sorry, not getting the support, I was thinking of speed. So as they go to the next pick, it wouldn't be surprising to maybe see something like a Invoker in the one role, since they do feel pretty comfortable with that.
Yeah, Invoker in the one role would be all right for them, taking a look at their play history. And remember, I haven't really done anything with HGT, so forgive me. I don't really know them that well. But I would guess they might also be thinking about a Lifestealer here. There are going to be able, I mean, they like to run them. They'll have the four staff for the Outward Devour to kind of get a bomb in. The problem is they don't really have the availability of like a Storm Spirit or a Timber Saw to really get in there. That being said, the Lifestealer does well up against Axe, does well up against Doom. They're going to grab a Nature's Prophet instead. And they're going to run that Pugna in that one spot, presumably OD mid and Nature's Prophet off lane. That is, I assume, going to be an aggressive try coming out of HGT. And we'll have to see if that ends up being the case.
I should make one correction. I was reading it. Had a quick brain fart when I read backwards on Terrain Protector. Terrain Protector has been picked up four times by them, and they have won all four games.
Yeah, Terrain Protector is very popular, and I'd be surprised if any team in the Chinese qualifiers have not picked him up at least once.
Actually, Speed has him down one time. So HGT is really very strong with the Terrain Protector. He's got the highest success rate on their team. So I look forward to seeing them play him here, since Terrain Protector is one of those heroes that can be very slow to get up and running. I'm looking forward to seeing a team that runs him at such a high level utilizing him.
All right, so Speed Gaming is going to go, and we just cast just a devastating Speed Gaming performance, and hopefully they've been able to shake it off. The tree is actually going to scout out. The tree with the little tree, big daddy and little baby going out, doing some scouting, and this is a really quirky way to start off your game. Everybody is just kind of playing keep your trash out of my yard here, not going into each other's lane. Refusing to cross those lines. They just want to know that their opponents are there. HGT had to put a line in the sand to make sure that Speed Gaming was not dropping in any wards for blocking pulls. But it doesn't look like there are going to be pulls. It does look like we're going to see that aggressive tri lane that I had called out. So maybe not, actually. The Witch Doctor is coming down here. So, okay, it is going to be a defensive tri lane. The Nature's Prophet is going to go all the way up there. XTT taking that off lane. And, they're going to be up against an aggressive tri lane coming out of Speed Gaming, though, which is another very predictable aggressive tri lane. With the Axe there and the heal coming out of the Shadow Wave as well as the Grave, it's going to be very difficult to deal with that kind of damage output from the counter helixes.
Absolutely. So I will have to leave introductions to you, as for right now, my heroes are literally skipping across the screen.
Oh, yeah, you're going to need to disconnect. This is Chinese server stuff. It's the same reason why in Dota TV I might sound like a robot right now. I'm not sure. I've been getting reports of it on and off all night. Yesterday, everybody was – I mean, I was in a game where AC disconnected like 14 times trying to get his heroes to stop skipping around.
So basically just disconnect and then rejoin.
Yeah, it's the routing between – you know, it's a great firewall. So that's what's causing that. And hopefully you'll be able to grab yourself some smooth screen time. Everything is silky smooth over here for the stream at the very least. And
I saw that on the stream, so that's why I wasn't too worried. So I'll reconnect and I will leave it to you.
Toffees is reconnecting. Sorry to talk over you on the stream there, but the people obviously in the ticket cannot hear you. So I'm going to just continue to talk out until you manage to get yourself back in here. We have ZSMJ on the Pugna. It's going to be pretty hot on that Witch Doctor. S is going to be rooted down on the Terrain Protector. In the mid, it's CTY taking the Outward Devour. And as already stated, it's XTT taking that offlane Nature's Prophet for HGT. And now for Speed Gaming, we have Mirana. That's going to be left around by Mai. In the mid lane, we have the Doombringer, and then we are going to have an aggressive tri lane here by ZRD on the Axe, JDH on the... Ooh, Axe could be going down here for first blood. There's very, very close. One more auto attack will do it. He even pops a salve, and that's going to give him just enough space. But the Terrain Protector is going to come in here with the teleport and secure the kill. Nice awareness out of XTT. He's going to walk in, grab himself a TP, and just immediately go back to his lane. Great call by XTT. That first blood money is well worth paying off for that TP cost. And where was I? I believe just the Dazzle played by Zip. I love how just about all these Chinese names are like three letters or three numbers, just kind of in conjunction. And I'm sure they make more sense if you know the culture, but I don't. So it just seems like three random letters or three random numbers for everybody as a unison sort of tag. Anyway, we are coming in here and Speed Gaming is already down one kill. HGT is feeling pretty confident, and I'm not positive, but I think I may have heard Toffees come back in. Maybe not.
Nope, still trying to connect to the server. I was just muting my mic so I wouldn't bother you.
Ah, I see. Okay, well, Pugna is actually, I was talking to an invisible man for those of you in the TV ticket, but we did end up missing out on that Pugna kill. The aggression coming out of this Axe, Darkseer, Dazzle. This is an interesting call to run it with the Darkseer instead of the Mirana. Obviously, this does allow the Axe to sit in a farming role and the Mirana to sit in an offlane farming role, so that's great, but what you miss out on is that extra stun. Darkseer does have the Ion Shell, so that damage on the Ion Shell along with the Counter Helix and the Berserker's Call is very potent, but you do have to make sure you can get in close enough for that Berserker's Call. Now, ZSMJ has gone down once. He is playing a farming role here on that Pugna. Pugna, not a hero we've seen a whole lot of here throughout any of the region's qualifiers, but certainly a hero who is going to provide a fair amount of push, and HGT's overall lineup is surprisingly push-oriented for this overall region. Now Toffees is back. You missed two kills. Nothing too serious. Come on in. Let me know what you think about this draft. Actually, I'm going to cut you off before you even start as the Surge does go out. There's going to be the call, and now Witch Doctor is forced to use his mana. He's forced to continue to heal, and he's forced to attack into that as ZSMJ is going to go ahead and try to turn around, move in. The Nature's Prophet thought about coming in, was trying to just bait them out. No, he's going to come in up the top end, grab that Dazzle, and now the Axe is forced to run. Still no kill after all of that on to the Witch Doctor. Great play, Kofar. Coming out of HGT, nice awareness coming out of XTT, and there is going to be the Pugna making sure that, oh boy, the Axe cannot get anywhere. He is going to be stunned out. He gets that Surge, turns around, just tries to scare them off for a half second, and now he's thinking about re-engaging, even though he has absolutely no regen here. Very, very interesting call. OD got himself a double damage rune meanwhile, and Toffees is back. Welcome back. Maybe not. I think Toffees might actually have disconnected again. He has disconnected again, so still working on that slideshow, Dota. I would say probably if he can't get it less slideshowy, he'll just have to do the best he can with it for a little while and then try again later. As once again, it's the great firewall, man. You can't get past it. You can't get past it, and you just got to kind of live with it. Unfortunately, we are coming toward the end. Well, fortunately and unfortunately in a way, because the games have been very fun. But we are coming toward an end for these Chinese qualifiers, and the Eurozone should have no such issues for we Western viewers in terms of the overall smoothness. Fortunately, also, the Twitch TV is going smooth. So those of you who are watching, and if I do sound like a robot on the Dota ticket, you can go ahead and swing over to twitch.tv/joinDOTAblue and catch this broadcast. Absolutely mic friendly, and everything's working out swell over there, as far as I'm aware, as long as I'm unmuted and everything, which it appears that I am. All right. So Darkseer is now being left alone down here, as this aggressive tri lane did not work out as well for Speed Gaming as they originally hoped. They're starting to rotate around. The Dazzle is doing some pulling. The Axe is chilling out in the fountain for the time being, but he'll probably go top as well. And they'll start supporting that Mirana. They can't really sustain this aggressive tri lane right now, considering the fact that they gave up two kills and a ton of time out of lane just running around the jungle. They just can't do it, so they are going to actually have the Axe maybe go into the jungle too, is another possibility. He is level 3, so he's there. All right, Toffees.
I'm back. I am still playing slideshow Dota, though, so I'll do my best to kind of go with stats, etc., to help out as much as I can, but I'm literally getting a...
I know exactly what you're getting, yeah.
It's about 8 seconds between each jump.
Yep. We did a full cast. I mean, literally, Pimp and I did a full half of a game, like 20 minutes yesterday on that.
Did it finally stop slideshow?
Yeah, it finally... Eventually, we just kept every, 4 or 5 minutes, dropped out, reconnected, see what we could do. I would recommend just closing Dota out rather than just dropping out.
That's a good idea. Actually, I'm going to try to do that real quick. All right. And I can still chat with you, though, because I think this... Is there a delay on the stream?
There is no delay on the stream, but people on the TV ticket won't hear you. So.
All right, so those of you on Dota TV, I will be back as quickly as I can. I apologize, Gorgon, for having to leave you on your own.
Oh, it's all right. As we do see, Darkseer is going to be able to search himself away, but this should be a pretty easy tier 1 tower. The push coming out of HGT is just too strong. They've got that Nether Blast, they've got the Treants, and they are here and ready to go. Now the Treant Protector himself is standing out here with his high base damage. He's actually been caught on the wrong side of this tower, but fortunately he's going to be able to walk around it. The Berserker's Call is going to be narrowly in range. There we go. Their boots are up on the Axe, so that's going to be enough. Another ward goes down, trying to make enough protection, but the Doombringer is just going to charge into it anyway. The Leech Seed is there, and he's also going to be sprouted in, so he's not going to be able to do anything else in this fight. The Axe, meanwhile, is going to go ahead and move in on the Moonlight Shadow, but he's not going to be able to move fast enough. The Haste Rune is up on the Doombringer, who's coming in under Moonlight Shadow and thinking about moving on that Treant, but he's not going to be able to get a kill anyway, especially since Doom is down. So, all things said and done, really nothing happened so far other than a couple TPs are required, and Bottom tier 1 tower remains a happy man for the time being. And, of course, Murata continues to free farm absolutely steadily. Outworld Devourer sitting on top of a Midas. That came out fairly early. And, yeah, I think this is its first use, so it came out around 720, 730, something like that. Pretty nice Midas. And Outworld Devourer also grabbing the last hit on the first tier 1 to go down. There are no TP reactions because they were all spent down bottom. Gold lead, 2,000 in favor of HGT, largely on the back of that tower. Experience lead, fairly negligible, about 500, which comes out to maybe half a level on average between all of the heroes, like half a level shared. So really not that significant at all. All right, Toffees is back, and let's do
slide
the old check.
Slideshow Dota has ended, so
right.
good call on the restarting the dotes.
Yeah, well, we did everything that we could possibly need to do there on that yesterday, so we found the patterns, we found the correlations, and we found the solution, and that is just kind of
Pippin Gorgon finding solutions since 1992.
I'm a problem solver, Toffees. You know, indeed. some of us spend all of our time fawning over famous casters, and some of us spend our time solving problems. I'm just gonna say that.
I see where you're going with that. That said, though, gold lead right now is about 4,000 the way of HGT. I haven't been able to see it, but it looks like HGT has been doing pretty well for themselves.
Oh, yeah. They're going to be pushing into this tier 2, and there needs to be TP reaction. There comes the Axe. That's going to be enough to back them up, but they force out the TP, which is exactly what they wanted. Axe is now 135 gold shorter, and will not be able to TP react if the Nature's Prophet wants to go push that top lane. He's on the opposite end.
I'll tell you what, the thing that I've been watching my fair amount. I mean, I think we all have watching some Chinese Dota over the last 2 days, which is something we don't get to watch as often as we'd probably like to.
Yeah.
But the one thing I see Chinese Dota do a lot that we see sometimes in Western, but not as much, is forcing out rotations, getting TPs, not only money spent, but on cooldown, and then trying to counter push in other lanes.
Yeah, I think you see a little bit less of the cool, calm, collected forced rotations. Like, oh, we're just going to kind of go up, and it's an understood gentleman's agreement that you're going to TP in and do nothing, and we'll back off. Like, it's sort of just sort of an understood trade in the same way that trading off supports is in the West. Like, you run in a 5-on-5 engagement, and both teams are like, okay, we're going to lose our support in this, and hopefully we'll take something else with it. But it's a gentleman's agreement, more or less, that we're just going to trade off supports here.
Oh, here's a big smoke move on the mid, though.
And now CTY is going to be called in that Berserker's Call. He's going to take a big, big counter Helix, and he should be going down here. He's silenced out by that Doom. And Axe is going to manage to grab that kill. Still no dunk up on him, though. He is only level 5 in 10 minutes.
Yeah, it was a good Doom. So when you watch that Doom go out, you think to yourself, well, was it necessary in the sense of the damage was there? What it does is it prevented that self-astral imprisonment that would have bought them time for TP reactions to come out.
Witch Doctor was there too, and the creeps were not. So Witch Doctor throwing out that cask and then buying enough time to get that Voodoo Restoration up to get the OD enough time to back out. One astral imprisonment probably would have actually been enough to get that OD out of there. And I'm sure he was spamming the button, but just could not quite get it off.
Yep. Saw it coming in. It was a great inception Doom. He didn't expect that because it was a really nice smoke rotation. And the Doom really had him in a good position. Plus, keep in mind, Radiant has this ward right here. So a false sense of security for OD as the gank was standing there. So he figured nothing in the offing. So a nice, nice play on that SPG.
All right, so coming out of Speed Gaming, they are sitting at 1-1 for the Pugna, or excuse me, for the Axe and the Dazzle, respectively. 1-0 for the, I'm going to cut that off because Axe is just going to run in from behind, get a very nice call. The mech goes out, and there's going to be the hammer coming out of the OD. One last auto attack coming out of that orb, and two orbs actually going out and get two kills. One on the Darksteer, one on the Axe, and now the Leap comes out, but the Nature's Prophet ulti, Wrath of Nature, is going out. The heal goes out from that Shadow Wave, but this is going to be a Tier 2 tower. It is a important Tier 2 tower because that is a Roshan response tower, and this is the period of time in the game where you're going to start worrying about that. Although against HGT's lineup, you're a little more worried about the potential for towers at the moment.
Yeah, no, great play. OD dropped the hammer, and that really kind of turned that fight around. It looks like, DC disconnect over there from the Darkseer, so get that fixed up. How do you get a disconnect to land?
I think that there was some sort of a issue, and he just popped out. You know, it happens. They paused. They maybe was not having the key. He was having keyboard issues or plug-in issues, or maybe his Dota was acting up. Dota acts up all the time.
Dota does act up all the time.
I mean, it's a well-programmed game, but something this complicated is going to have glitches and it's going to have errors, and they do their best. But, you know, sometimes you can't buy items at the store. Sometimes your hero doesn't move. Sometimes, in my case, every time I load a game, I have no cursor. So things like that.
That's true. But it's a free game, so you can't really complain. Exactly. HGT, 6,000 gold to the advantage right now. XP starting to take a disturbing lead for them as well, which I think Speed Gaming needs to kind of address here. That OD is now level 10 compared to the rest of the map, who's sitting at level 8.
Yeah, they should be in the lead right now, though. They have such a better push lineup, and also their early game team engagement lineup is much better. The Darkseer goes late very hard. He scales into the late game by raises up multiple percents in terms of win rate. He goes up, I think, a total of like 8 or 9, maybe even 10% from the very early to the very late lasting games for win rate. The Mirana is one of the highest winning heroes for a dual core lineup. The Doombringer goes late very hard as well. The Grave never falls off at any stage of the game. So looking at Speed Gaming, they need to buy themselves time to get to the late game, or at least the near late game, mid game, like 30-35 minute point. And HGT is doing a very good job of not providing that opening. They are not playing this Chinese Dota that we just saw playing against Speed Gaming, where it's like, well, we'll just wait another 30 minutes before we really push in.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's a pretty heavy push strat out of HGT. Yeah, I mean,
very heavy.
The idea of taking
all right, from the back end, there's going to be the Tree Protector actually getting a very nice overgrowth onto the Axe, who's trying to come in and grab himself under course of Moonlight Shadow, but the tree will go down for the trade. However, the Axe much more important here. The Weave goes out defensively and gets all four of those allies. And there is going to be the OD managing to grab out that Dark Seer. Looks like he is not going to be able to get away. There's going to be the Sprout and the Witch Doctor popping up that ult. He's going to secure that kill. Very nice play all around coming out of HGT. And they're going to be able to push in on this at least a little bit. Force out the TP reaction coming out of the Axe. They're going to get the Treants up, and the Axe is TPing in. They're going to stay and fight it, though. They want to at least get a little bit of damage on this tower. They do have the Pugna here, so why not? Pugna has full mana as well. He has a mechanism up, so if anybody gets low, he's going to be able to heal him up. And look at the Witch Doctor just pumping out that Voodoo Restoration from the rear end, actually trying to pull those creeps back, but he just can't do anything against the zoo. Those Treants are absolutely wrecking.
And honestly, basically what happened is Doom rotated down to the bottom lane after that. They lost the engagement on the first tower, thinking they wouldn't go for two. And the second that they saw him down there on that middle lane, they knew they were good to push. And Doom just wasn't able to respond fast enough to give them any. Because he right now, he's Blink Dagger Doom combo, which is really the initiation that they're going to be utilizing for the next 5 to 10 minutes. And without him there, it just made HGT comfortable on that push.
Yeah, OD sitting on level 11, Nature's Prophet level 9, Mirana level 9, and everybody else is 8 or below. However, the pack is fairly close. And if we look at the experience, it's not even 4,000 gold in lead of HGT. A lot of that is on the back of the Midas that has been on the OD for quite some time, and the Nature's Prophet who got his Midas up as the Mirana did. So they're going to go ahead and try to get their last Outreacher Tower. The Nether Blast is there. There is not a Glyph for some time still. And Nature's Prophet is waiting on the wings, trying to make sure. And there's going to be absolutely no flanking going on. No funny business. This is a free tower, and you are not allowed to engage on it. Rules of the road. All right, Doom is going to come in here. He throws down the Stomp. He does not hit a whole lot of anything. He manages to Doom out the Pugna, though. The Witch Doctor throwing up another huge ulti. However, the Grave is there. The Astral Imprisonment is going to open up a little bit of space, so the Doombringer is not going to have the Grave when he comes back. There's one more orb. It is going to get the Darkseer. The Doombringer is very low and running around the outside. He can't come in to help this Dazzle. Dazzle is getting pretty low as well. And, oh, great arrow!
Nice arrow.
And this should be a pretty long stun. The Stealth Astral Imprisonment and the, oh, Nature's Prophet using the fake teleport to buy enough space. And between the mechanism of the Pugna and the Voodoo Restoration coming out of the Witch Doctor and the Urn, already full health for our
That's
World
crazy.
Devourer.
That
Look
is
at
crazy.
That.
So that was an epically well-thrown arrow by Mirana,
right?
And that kill should have happened, but it was just beautiful play by HGT.
They didn't have the output yet, and I don't think the Mirana... Well, did she have the Star Storm up that whole time, or was it on cooldown?
I think it was on cooldown.
Yeah,
but I mean,
it must have been, because she would have gotten the kill if she had called it.
That fake TP from Nature's Prophet was just beautiful because it forced Mirana to back out of fear and bought just enough time for OD to survive.
Yeah, that fake TP, it costs nothing, man. It is absolutely free. If you don't actually finish off that animation, it's one of the few spells in the game that you can literally start the spell animation and it will not register until you actually get away, which is huge. It is huge for baiting out those situations where you make your opponents run. Oh, the double stun, the overgrowth is there as well. This is going to be a very dead Mirana as well as the Axe. No, Mirana maybe actually going to win. There's the four staff. They're going to dive into the tier fours. The Mirana is going to be graved, and she's going to walk away no problem. And
is this Chinese Dota?
This is something Dota. This is going to be a GG probably in about 18 minutes if there is not a huge turn from Speed Gaming. They have just been absolutely flustered. They have no idea how to handle this sort of aggression. They don't even have the vacuum wall up yet. And they just got level 1 wall up, and who cares about level 1 wall? You need level 2. Larsier is still level 8, and he got that wall out of desperation. He's got level 2 vacuum and level 1 wall, which is essentially not even. It's like, yeah, you have it, but...
It's like a tickle.
Yeah, it's like having a pog collection. Sure, you have it, but who cares?
I care. I love pogs. I used to. Anyway, that said, though, it's been great. I mean, the gold lead's already at 15,000 for HGT, so they're dangerously close to hitting 1,000 gold per minute on the team farm. And it's just... It really, I mean, honestly, HGT looks like they pulled in almost a Western strategy push strat here, no. And SPG was just not prepared for it.
Well, I will say that however much we talk about East-West styles, I mean, push strats are not a foreign concept to China. You see them a fair amount. Right. You just don't see them as often. Right now, you see it in every game just about in the West, and it's just not that popular right now in China. It's not like this is like, oh... A Chinese team discovered a push strat. Like, this right. is... this is.
They're not they're not discovering it. It is just, I guess, in the overall stereotype of Chinese style of play. And the thing is that they're not only... When I say Western style of push strat, I don't mean the fact that they drafted push heroes. They're executing, and their fights are going a lot deeper than typical Chinese fights. Like, they are chasing past racks to make sure that they secure kills.
Yeah, it's not just the push. It's also the aggression. The maneuvering and placement in the overall tactics, saying we're okay taking risks and diving towers for the high reward of knocking down more of your heroes. Odin's going to walk right into that area, and that's a huge bummer because now he's not going to be able to engage. There's the blink coming out of the Doombringer. He's going to be in, though, and he's taking a fair amount of damage from Nether. What a huge overgrowth, followed by the ulti of the Witch Hunter. Their cask is bouncing around. There's nothing they can do. There has to back up in that Darkseer. Darkseer is probably going to go down on the top end. Meanwhile, on the bottom end, we see the Axe go down, and now the Doombringer is going to be pulled into the fight. And he manages to get himself away.
Nether Ward put in some work on that one.
Right. I mean, and did you see that overgrowth up onto... Yeah.
That's insane.
GG, well played. Coming out of 1845. Speed Gaming is all but gone from the International here for 2014. HGT finding themselves a saving grace. If they are lucky, there will be a couple losses on some key teams coming out here. And they might be moving on to some tiebreakers, trying to move into that top four slot. So, I want to thank Toffees for coming in for the 4 or 5 minutes of this game that he was here. You can find him over at Toffees_Dota2. My name is, of course, Gorgon the Wonder Cow. You guys have been listening to me all day today and all day yesterday here on Join Dota Blue. You can catch me at GotCowDota on Twitter. I'd love to see you guys throw me some comments, some questions about the game. Just, you know, say hi, concerns, general conspiracy theories, recipes.
Angry rants,
criticisms of my casting, criticisms of my beard I sometimes get. You know, just basically run the gambit. Whatever you want to send me, send it to me. Just hit me a follow first. We might have some tiebreakers for you guys here coming out on this channel a little bit later, but for the time being, I think we're going to tear this channel down. We don't have any more scheduled matches as far as I'm aware. I am going to check just to be absolutely certain. So if this channel just goes down without any warning very soon, it's because there are no more games left for us until we get to the tiebreaker round. Yeah. So,
and if there is a tiebreaker, we'll tweet it out to you guys. Absolutely. So yet another reason to go follow Gorgon over on the Twitter. And I'll put both of the links up in chat so that you guys know where to find him and where to find me if you're interested.
All right, guys. Thanks for tuning in. And please do stick around and just make sure that there are no more games. Of course, you can also go over to all the other EU Hub channels here at Join Dota to make sure you're catching all of the games on Twitch. Or you can go in the Dota TV client as well. So once again, thanks for tuning in. And have yourselves a good morning, afternoon, or evening, depending your location.